I'm shadow banned right now. Nobody's gonna see this, but I gotta talk about this movie Smile, bruh. If you don't know, then you probably just gonna think this a regular horror movie, but they was really trying to tell you something in this jump. So if you don't know what the movie is yet, it's about an entity that enters people's minds and lives and thrives off their trauma for a couple of days and then kills them when the week is over. And the demon will project itself into your real life, but nobody else will see it. But you'll see it as somebody you know, or somebody you know that died years ago, something traumatic, you know what I'm saying? And whenever this entity is projecting itself into their reality, all they feel is an energy that something bad is about to happen. So spoiler alert coming now, if you wanna watch the movie, turn this TikTok off because I'm about to decode this jump. So like I said, the entity lives in your mind and it just wants to kill you, right? But if you die while the entity is in your mind, then he will die too. So that's why somebody has to witness it, so the energy can be passed on. Energy doesn't die, it can only be transferred. So the entity will kill the host while somebody is watching, and if you're watching somebody die, that instantly sets you in a low vibration, you're in a fear state. Now that entity can enter you. Where is he gonna enter at? What is the window to your soul? That's why when the first girl I just showed you died, it zoomed in on the witness's eye. That's why when the main character died, it zoomed in on the witness's eye, because where was the entity going? It was entering their vessel, their mind, through their eyes. And they showed a lot of upside down angles in the movie. Personally, I thought it was because when these entities are just flying around looking for a new host, this might be their perspective. They even mentioned this in the movie, it thrives off your trauma, it thrives off of your lower vibrations. So when you're feeling guilt, shame, fear, when you're feeling chaotic. So when it was time for the host to kill, to sacrifice for the entity, then it had to be gruesome, all right? It had to be nasty. It had to be really a vicious death so the entity would really appreciate it. Very low vibrational, very chaotic. And what this movie is representing is it's just representing low vibrational entities in general, all right? They're gonna make it a little dramatic, but it's just representing low vibrational entities, and it'll come in all forms of ways. So lust, anger, jealousy, shame, guilt. This one was guilt and shame. Because at the end of the movie, it was time for the main character to die. But she was already tracking how this was going to go down. She didn't have to kill herself. She didn't have to sacrifice herself. She had to sacrifice somebody. But regardless, if nobody's there to witness a death, then the entity will die in her mind. That's what she was planning on doing. So she went back to her childhood home where she left her mom to die. Because she had mental issues, she left her mom to die. She went back to that childhood home to, I guess, face that issue and die there. And then the entity showed itself as her mom. Yeah, I don't got enough time to finish this video, but I want to talk about why that entity was burning in a fire, because that is symbolic. So give me a reason to make a part 2.
Are using your African sciences. Like, for instance, Masons call it climbing Jacob's ladder. They have 33 degrees. This is because 85% of white people are born with the calcified pineal gland. So your spine is Jacob's ladder. You have 33 vertebrae in your spine. The 33rd vertebrae is right here. Where your 5 physical senses are. So by a white person, like, you have what you call kundalini energy, the serpent energy. Many of y'all go look up the Cardicus, Red Cross Blue Shield. They have the 2 serpents that go up the thing and they have the wings. They stole this symbol from the black African Egyptian Imhotep. This symbol was on his hospitals. The serpents represent kundalini energy that travels up your spine. Once this energy travels up the spine of the black person, it pushes open the pineal gland like a trap door. In the third ventricle of the brain of a black person, they have a dark liquid there. This liquid spills out of the third ventricle into the fourth ventricle, stimulates the brain, and this is what gives you psychic ability. The darker your flesh is like basically a meter that lets you know how full this is. So the blacker somebody is, the fuller the liquid is in their ventricle. Me, I'm brown, so my ventricle is probably like 85% full. And then the light skin you get, the more weaker the melanin you get. The melanin that sits within the ventricle of your third ventricle of your brain is getting lower and lower until you get to a white person. And they liquid is so low or little to none that their bodies know that they don't have to use it. So they pineal gland is calcified. So when a kundalini energy shoots up their spine and it hits the door is locked. So the reason Masons have... they stop at 33 degrees is because when the kundalini shoots up their spine, it doesn't leave the 33rd vertebrae to the sixth sense. The 33rd vertebrae represents the five senses. The mind represents the sixth sense. A white person or Masons understand they can't access the sixth sense at the frequency of a black person. So this is why Masons stop at the 33rd degree. This is why they call it Jacob's ladder. Because remember, Jacob is Yaqub, the one who grafted them. When Jacob grafted them, he made them weaker, so their ladder, their spine, is not able to get on the pineal gland. This is why in the Bible, when it talks about Jacob went to the land of Peniel and wrestled with God, Peniel, pineal gland, God, highest extent of the mind, which uses elements and matter to express itself.
Y'all don't know the amount of fear I had yesterday. Sorry y'all ain't seen me post, I've been banned for 5 days. But this video is for entertainment purposes only. Anyway, so look y'all, yesterday, I started my period. Now you're probably asking, why would I have fear about that? Well, me stepping into my goddess energy, my high vibrational new form. But if I haven't told y'all, I've been having ascension symptoms. I don't know what ascension symptoms are. It is when your multidimensional spiritual body is going through an upgrade or a shift. I have been feeling real disoriented, like I'm not 3D anymore. I was feeling unusual aches, mostly because you are purifying blocked energy from the 3D. I've also been hearing and seeing clear as day my ancestors talking to me and flashes of visions. I've been feeling out of body, heightened sensitivity, my desire for food has like gone all the way to zero. And I also felt numbness in my body for a full week. And not to mention the on again, off again ringing in my ears. If y'all know me, I really do not like taking anything artificial or pills at all. I don't like putting that type of stuff in my body. But when my period comes, I have to take it because of the terrible pain. But it made me just think. Because my body has been upgrading, why don't I test the waters and see if I still feel cramps? And y'all don't know how afraid I was. So my period came. Normally the cramps hit like 30 minutes or 15 minutes in. So I'm just sitting there waiting like, what's gonna happen? Because I told you I wasn't taking any pain pills. An hour later, I felt nothing. We're 3 hours in, I still don't feel nothing. The whole day goes by with no cramps. Now I'm not saying don't try this at home. But if you have been going through the same ascension symptoms as me, maybe try it. Who knows what our bodies are capable of right now. Y'all stay dangerous, but if y'all want to see more of my content that is uncensored because of this app, go to my YouTube channel.
By now, y'all should know we've been taught everything in reverse. Okay, nighttime is unnatural. Nighttime is unnatural. That shit shouldn't even surprise you, for real, for real. Understand, it's plenty to have multiple suns, and these suns are returning, right? That's why it's getting hotter slowly. I don't know if y'all been paying attention to the sky lately at night, but it's been a lot more illuminated. It don't even look dark. You feel me? It looks like it's just permanently sunrise. You know what I'm saying? I know y'all been paying attention to and seeing these videos, right, of it being very illuminated at like 10 o'clock. You feel me? Like, I've seen a bunch of videos already like that. With that being said, a lot of billionaires, millionaires get up between 3, 4, 5 in the morning, you feel me, because they understand that that's when their brain is working the best, right? We are sleeping during this time, y'all. You feel me? Everything is in reverse. When in reality, we're supposed to be up at night. When a baby comes to this realm, you know what I'm saying, they are up. Like, oh, they keep your ass up at night. Why is this? You feel me? Because they understand that, oh, this is really the daytime. You feel me? It shouldn't even surprise you that I'm saying that we used to have multiple suns. You feel me? Because the mountains, you feel me, are huge trees. The mountains are nothing but tree stumps, y'all. You know what I'm saying? So with that being said, this used to be a magical realm. Why were the trees so big? We were even bigger than. Everything was bigger than. Why? The sun, the second sun that we had, you feel me? Right? It was making everything more magnified, right? We're neuromelanated beings, carbonated beings, all right? The sun, photon energy, makes us stronger. I understand why they put a moon in the sky and tell you that the moon fucking reflects the sunlight. And it's bullshit. We are photon energy beings, okay? That's why we have multiple suns, because we feed off that energy of the sun, okay? This moon is anti-photon energy, all right? Complete opposite, all right? It's harming us, okay? And when there's a full moon, the ocean gets angry, you feel me? Ocean tide rising and shit. People going crazy, you feel me? It's why they show you werewolves getting strong in the moonlight, you feel me? Because the moon is an enhancer to everything that's unnatural on the planet, okay? Been taught everything in reverse once again. All this shit ain't what it seems, okay? I ain't saying that there ain't real moons on other planets and shit, but on this specific planet, we just had two suns for the moment, and there's way more than two suns returning, because that shit that happened ain't never happening again, you feel me? We're gonna make sure, you know what I'm saying? The more suns it is, the stronger we is, you feel me? The hotter it get, the stronger we gonna get. You feel me? I've been having these dreams where I've been seeing multiple suns in the sky, and that it's been daylight as fuck in the middle of what is supposed to be 2 a.m. and shit. Don't forget about the daylight saving time bill that they passed early on this year, man. I'm gonna show y'all that. Remember the daylight saving time bill that they approved early on this year? They made the shit permanent. I told y'all to ask yourself, who had the power to do such a thing, man? These bitches know what's coming. You feel me? I want y'all to ask yourself, you feel me? How do you feel under the moon? You feel me? First, how do you feel under the sun? You know what I'm saying? And why does your brain work the best when you're asleep? 3 to 5. Like, please ask yourself and get an understanding. You feel me? Think about all this shit, brother. This shit deep.
I'm about to talk about shrooms for the third time, y'all, and this is going to be the best one. Because do y'all know what the mycelium network is? Why does it connect all plant life on the planet? And why does it look just like the neuroplasticity in our brain? Look, so if you don't know what the mycelium network is, read this. And basically, it is it's an intelligent form of fungus that has been around for millions, hundreds of millions of years. It has seen everything and survived through everything. Like, I personally think it's what keeps the planet going. But like I said, this form of intelligence, because just calling it a fungus does not do it enough justice. This form of intelligence has seen it all. So look, this is the life cycle of a fungus, right? And the mycelium part is when the fungus is at its strongest phase. But the part that we eat is just the fruit, all right? It's the reproduction of it. And the spore is like leaving the seed. But peep how the mycelium look and peep how the roots of the mushroom look. All right, that's called hyphae. That hyphae is what spreads in the soil and connects from plant to plant, tree to tree. All right, so let me show y'all this video real quick.
The transfer of nutrients. They then began to study flow patterns within the fungus, making videos of the complex patterns of movement. You can actually see here that the fungus stops the flow of nutrients in one direction and reverses it, sending them back the other way. The scientists think that this is our first look into how fungi can redirect nutrients in response to their environment. It could even be that these oscillations of molecules represent some kind of communication. Could this be how these complex fungal networks transmit information?
I'm about to make a part two because I don't want this video to be too long. But the key points to take away from that was it can redirect nutrients in response to its environment. The word communication, the word network, and the word information. It's extremely tapped into the environment because it's connected to every plant. It's sensing everything and it's communicating information between plants and other environments. Part two coming, bro.
Don't give yourselves to these unnatural men, with machine minds and machine hearts. You are not machines, you are men.
All right, back to the topic of Isaac Cappy. The whistleblower that many people chose to ignore. Just look in my comments, you'll find all kinds of ignorant people that ignored this man who blew the whistle on Hollywood. And instead of paying attention and listening to what the man was saying, they chose to label people like us who listen to this man who is a whistleblower. But where's the evidence? Hello, he is the evidence, you dumb fuck. Rule number one, if you have not researched or listened to a thing that people have been saying about Isaac Cappy, you have no opinion whatsoever on this matter. All right, let's get to it. So Tom Hanks has this weird fucking fetish where he takes photos of stranded gloves, and stranded hats on the ground. In this particular photo, which you could find on his Instagram page, there's a writing on the ground that says SRC USA. And if you were to research this in a Russian search engine during the pandemic, it led you to compromising photos of children. I know this for a fact because during the pandemic, me and my sister went to the Russian search engine and we looked up SRC USA, and sure enough, compromising photos of children. Fast forward, there were so many people searching SRC USA in this particular search engine that the Russians had to shut it down because it was making too much noise. And after all that went viral, Tom Hanks decided to delete all of his comments on all of his Instagram posts because everybody was lambasting him. Thousands of comments, and he deleted them. Now let's get back to Isaac Cappy.
A pedophile. Tom Hanks, folks, is a pedophile. Sorry to... I'm sorry if this is kind of bursting your bubble. All this information is new. But it's time that this comes out into the open because we are going to change the way everything works.
That video was just an example of the back and forth that Isaac Cappy and Tom Hanks had. Now, if you noticed in that video, the handkerchief was being run over by the camper on the other handkerchief. Coincidence? I don't think so. Anyways, Cappy made a ton of videos and a lot of them got deleted, but one of them still exists on YouTube, and this is the last video he made before he was suicided. You need to go and watch this video if you don't know. Here's another one of Tom Hanks' weird fucking photos where he takes a photo of a glove that was found stranded on Route 66. And below he says, historic Route 66 roadkill? I hope not. Being the same route that Isaac Cappy was found dead on. And he wrote this in April 2019, April 4th. And the comments are all deleted because he was being lambasted. And Isaac Cappy was found dead on Route 66 a month later.
Have you noticed lately everybody been staring at you, right? You ain't did nothing. You just walk outside and people just like, damn, who is that? They just staring at you. You don't even know what the fuck you doing. That's because your energy and your aura is starting to get brightened at this time, man. You are activating into your higher self. You can't see it, but you can feel it. I know you feel a little different. You know what I'm saying? I know you feel a little lighter, but also you start to, you know, get anxiety about things easier. That's because you start to endure a lot of other people's energy. You are a natural empath, naturally. It's a lot of stuff that's happening different in your life, man. Stuff you can't explain. You can't explain it because it's unexplainable. It's a feeling. It's a feeling, man. So if you actually constantly keep getting up in the middle of the night, just know that these are the times when you need to start, you know, writing down your dreams, or you need to start paying attention to what time it is too, because you might wake up at a specific time. If you keep waking up at the same time every night, then that's a message there for you. Look up that angel number. Look up the spiritual meaning of that number. Because that's a message that your ancestors trying to get in contact with you, man. It's a lot of stuff that's changing in your life. If you don't want to believe it yourself, I know sometimes you'll wake up and be like, man, that shit ain't real. Yes, it is. This ain't gonna happen. Yes, it is. This ain't what's going on. Yes, it is. It's going on in your life. You are the one that I'm talking about. You are the chosen one. You are. So people gonna look at you like the chosen one. People gonna see you like the chosen one. You gotta see yourself as a chosen one, though. That's why you got a lot of people that hate you, but you got a lot of people that love you, though. You got a lot of people that stare at you all day, but you got a lot of people that turn their nose up at you. And you ain't doing nothing but being your authentic self. That's not you. You ain't out here hating nobody or no shit like that. They recognize who you are. Either you make people extremely happy or extremely mad. You are the in-between, family. You are the in-between. Trust and believe that you are. Trust me, you are. That's why a lot of your family members look at you like they look at you. They've been seeing it your whole life. They've been seeing it. They've been seeing it. That's why they want to hurry up and try to count you out first. That's why they want to hurry up and try to get your name, you know, talked bad about first. So when you finally do step into your higher calling, your name could already be slandered. But the Most High not going for that. Not at all. You have a big missing. So whatever they said about you, it's reversed now. So the things they talked about you is actually being said about them, and people starting to see them for narcissists. Thank you so much for the King Crown. They try to make you look bad, family. They try to make you look bad. But guess what? The narcissist is being revealed. The narcissist is being revealed at this time, family.
Five of the most unhealthiest struggle meals. Number one, ravioli. This some shit Maya eat every day. The sauce used in ravioli got high fructose corn syrup. Also, most of the protein in this food don't even come from the meat itself. It come from soy. And you know what they say about them soy boys. High estrogen levels, feminine. Number two, white bread. White bread got bleach in it. The flour used to make white bread is chemically bleached. Just like you bleach your clothes, when you eat white bread, you're also eating residual chemical bleach. Number three, oatmeal. Oatmeal is number three on the list of the foods with the most fluoride in it. Number three. As y'all know, fluoride does damage the pineal gland. Number four, lunch meat. Eating deli meats every day could seriously impact your heart health. Like, bro, this is raw meat. All they do is boil it or broil it. They do something to it, but they don't cook it for real. And it's classified as a class one carcinogen. Number five, noodles. Noodles got high levels of monosodium glutamate, and this could damage your mind.
The Ankh is an electromagnetic device. You see it in the hands of the gods. You also see us carrying a scepter, which is a device we use to move stones for pyramids, which we use to harness electromagnetic energy. We also use a jed, which is the spine of God, to transfer consciousness. It too is an electromagnetic device. The sa is used for protection. Shinu represents the sun or eternity. Ra is the falcon-headed god. Ra is the one above. Seba is the dimension of freedom. It's the fourth dimension. It's time. Hathor is the mother of God and the spirit of fertility. Horus's eye is the pineal gland. We are the Kemites. We never called ourselves Egyptians. That's a Greek name. Our education protocol is called the Kemetic Mystery System. Scholars from around the world came to Kemet, Timbuktu, the Gold Coast, and other regions nearby to learn about astronomy, botany, pharmacology, geography, chemistry, and most importantly, geometry. But none has ever completed the 20-year education process. You all hail the Greek Pythagoras for his theorem. However, we used that equation almost 2,000 years before his birth. You call Hippocrates the father of medicine. His teacher was a Kemite named Imhotep, who lived thousands of years before him. Our universities and temples were destroyed. Your current civilization is ran off of the incomplete wisdom of the Greeks. Those were our impatient students. The time is now for you to ascend in consciousness to receive the downloads of our technology. Meditation, sacred medicine, and actively seeking the truth is necessary to ascend. Through mathematics, you will exist for all eternity. You will understand that you have always been here and you'll always be here.
There's huge conspiracy theories about the Denver airport. It's huge. There's giant bunkers for like the end of the world for the elite to come and stay safe after everybody else dies. There's a giant horse statue, and people say it symbolizes the apocalypse and the end of the world because it has bright red glowing eyes. The artist that designed it, during the construction of the horse, a piece of the horse fell off, landed on him, cut his leg off, and he bled to death. And so people say this thing is obviously evil because even the guy who constructed it died from it.
Okay, you know who Edgar Allan Poe is?
Yeah.
Is he the one that like would quote like, oh, the Raven and all
yeah,
that
yeah,
shit?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, bro, I heard this thing about this dude that was so interesting to me the other day. I guess in 1838, Edgar Allan Poe, he went to sleep this one night and he had a dream that, and it wasn't even about him. I think it was three or four guys that were on a boat. He doesn't know who these guys are. He just had a dream about these random
He's
dudes.
On the boat with them, though?
He's not on the boat with them. He's just, just like, it's basically like you're watching a movie. Oh, and you're okay, seeing okay, this okay. play out, but it was in his dream. These four dudes are on a boat, and I guess they got shipwrecked, but in order to survive, they ended up eating one of their homies.
Oh,
right?
Shit.
The maniest shit about it is hella years later, bro. Like, you know, after this dude had that dream, in 1884, hella years later, bro, these dudes, those four guys, just like in Edgar Allan Poe's dream, these four dudes went out to sea. They ended up getting shipwrecked. They ended up eating their homie, bro.
Oh, shit.
And hella people were just like, bruh, what the fuck? Like, what are the odds? And then this was the weirdest shit, too. In Edgar Allan Poe's dream, he heard them say the guy's name. That
got eaten?
That got eaten. And when the news came out about the guy, like, you know, these guys that got lost down the sea and then they ended up eating dude, because people found out about the story, the guy's name was exactly the same name.
Oh, shit. Did Edgar, like, write the story about before, this? Like, they went out on,
yeah,
into sea?
Yeah, yeah. I don't know if he wrote about this, but I think he talked about it to, like, somebody he was with or whatever, fuck, and that's how, you know, I'm even able to tell this. But
that's insane.
Yeah, bro, and it was the same name and everything.
Do you think, like,
he was psychic?
Or do you think it was just a weird coincidence?
I don't fucking know, bro. I don't know.
That's
I think,
what I'm saying, bro.
Like, I that's what I'm saying. How do you explain stuff like that? Because, bro,
what are the odds?
What are the odds, bro? That you
exact
got that,
same name, exact same number of people.
Like you pinpointed it. Like a that's insane. Bro. You had his name right. This number of people. You know,
maybe he was astro projecting.
Whoa.
Into the future for some weird reason or something.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't know, because he was on some crazy shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah, bro. A lot of shit he was writing about.
Yeah,
was crazy,
bro.
Too,
it was
know?
Insane.
He was ahead of his time. So I don't know, bro. When I heard that shit, I was just like, bro, what the fuck?
Damn, that's crazy, bro. Poe. So the other three people came back to shore and just pretty much said, like, yeah, we ate that motherfucker.
I don't think they told them, but they came
people
back
found
and
out. Yeah,
it was
yeah.
pretty obvious what happened.
Holy fuck.
Yeah, crazy as fuck.
Okay, this is the comment I've been looking for right here. See, if you know, you know, right? The Vatican owns the United States Corporation Company. Under the guise of the U.S. government, the United States Corporation Company is a corporation. See, we like to say that it is a corporation to each other, but no, it actually is a corporation. A corporation that technically owns you. So the Vatican owns the corporation that owns you, the mini corporation, and they selling you on the stocks and bonds markets. This is not new knowledge. And I'm not going to sit here and act like I'm a genius at this or whatever, that I've known this for a long time. You know what I mean? But the reality is that if you know something, tell people. The Sister QV Trust of 1666, a lot of us are tied to that trust. Anybody that has a birth certificate in the United States has a trust, right? The Sister QV Trust, you're part of that trust, right? Which means they have a bond on you, which means they have insurance on you, which means they trade you. This is the exact trust that CPS, Child Protective Services, uses to take children out of their home illegally so that they could get the money for that trust. They get $300,000 something per child that they take, and they get it from the trust. This is real stuff. So if the people, the Vatican, who is out of the U.S. jurisdiction because the Vatican is owns the United States Corporation Company, if they own them and they own you and they're taking their assets out of the systems that they created for your demise, what does that tell you? That means it's time to get serious, people. Now, as for the people, we're talking about, as for African-Americans, right? Mislabeled as African-Americans, you all are mislabeled. You are the real Indians. You are the real Aborigine people of the Americas, right? The real Aborigine people. And so the time is now coming to where we're taking our land back. But you got to know who you are, what you are, that you're not a part of this U.S. jurisdiction. This stuff is real, folks. Right? This stuff is real. So we going back to our old original governments. Everybody is. I'm not just talking about us in general. Everybody is a part of an Aborigine government that they abandoned. And it's time to get back to it. So, you know, take it how you want to take it, but hey, tribe up.
Revolution is real. Now we rise. Give my life for this shit. Yeah.
The being descended from Mayan ruins, Larry Hoover's fine, it's the Malcolm X of the music. And walking in your purpose, then why you walking, you're useless.